his 10th touchdown of the season, second of the game. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude of the group that's behind, because they were counting on getting into the game a little bit more, right? Maybe they get the first score. That doesn't happen.
Here's Colton Schmidt now, as he's on to punt for Buffalo. And now a high kick here as he'll try to hang it up there. Pretty woeful there, just 23 yards on the punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Atlanta now coming out on the field. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? I mean, they score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
And he'll take this one for about four, up to the 40.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Toss. He'll take this from the 40 up to the 45 for a gain of five. So following the run, we'll see what they do here on third down. Now a handoff looking right. He's got a first down and then some inside the 40. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. Almost unstoppable on the ground there, as that one is good for 39.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. And now the offense operates in the red zone. From the red zone now, here's Ryan on first down. Connects with Sanu right side. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Halfback sent in motion. On second down, Ryan trying to drop one in, but it's incomplete.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss it? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah.
What happened?
During film study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it.
6 points go by the wayside on that one.
Oh, and now he bowls him over. Give him a gain of four, able to convert, and that's it. It's up first and goal now. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defensive side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he gets in. Touchdown, Atlanta. A great play there. His third touchdown of the game, number 11 on the year. And the Falcons will extend their lead. He keeps carrying the ball into the end zone, and in this one, he's sort of carrying the team on his back.
He's the reason that they leave.
Here's Colton Schmidt now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. Getting set to go again as we look at the back heading onto the field again. He has had a whale of a game. In the third quarter, you're already over 200 yards. I don't know what more he can do at this point.
Not a whole lot, and what he has found is that zone that we always talk about, where every carry feels great. Every carry potentially is a sprint to the end zone, and all he wants to do is ride it as long as this game goes on.
Yeah, now he's just thinking 300 yards maybe. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
A Falcon first down, Ryan to his young tight end, Hooper.
Now, coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there, and how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Now Ryan. And finding the tight end, Hooper. Down the numbers. There he goes. Touchdown, Falcons. Austin Hooper. His third touchdown now on the year. Following the fumble recovery, it's Ryan. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it, and it took the ball off course.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
And he almost intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their first. And it's third down now. The Falcons on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 10. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he'll get it down here to the 43. It's a gain of 5, but it'll lead to a fourth down. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. And a good job here by the Falcons. Their hands team able to recover it. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell.
There he goes, right side. He cuts it middle, and he's got some room. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. A big play there. 48 yards. And the Falcons continue to pour it on. And that rushing touchdown is fourth, puts him just one shy of the NFL record in a single game.
And we all know he would love to get to that record and even beyond it.
So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. he's free. Now they're down big here in the fourth. They had to try the onside kick. Can't fault him for the effort, at least.
No, you can't at all. And if nothing else, now you've put something that you're trying to practice, right, that you've worked on into a game situation, and now you can go back and dissect it. So if you need it again sometime, maybe you'll find a better way to do it. But, yeah, this game's pretty much done for them.
Now they'll run it on the toss. He'll be stopped short of the 25. The nice move couldn't free him. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Now they'll run it on the toss. Evades him at the 20. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. Starting to really smell a 4-0 start right now. You can't ask for a better first quarter of the season than that.
And you're not supposed to look ahead, but guess what?
You're going to?
They have to. Because when you get to 4, if you get to 4-0, you're not just thinking playoffs now. You're thinking about, okay, this team has the capabilities of winning a Super Bowl. They could very well be the best team in the NFL at this moment.
I think they play. Here's Colton Schmidt now, as he's on for the fifth time here today. Let's go, 46 on his first kick, this one in that neighborhood as well. This is taken around the 12. 12 yards on the return that time, and we have reached the 2-minute warning. Meanwhile, in Foxborough, there in the fourth quarter. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. The Pats have moved back in front. That's a game that has been back and forth all afternoon. Tom Brady with 3 touchdown passes to help lead the way. Getting late in the fourth now, Charles. 2-minute warning just around the corner.
Yeah, some teams just want to get to that spot, take a breath, and then come out and attack for the rest of the game.
A handoff as they run the counter play. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Now before this second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. They've got a second down now as they look to salt this one away. They run a draw here on second down. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. It'll be a gain of 11, and that'll lead here to a third down.
In today's NFL, when you get teams in long yardage situations with your defense, you're really going to go to your speed packages. You're going to get smaller, lighter guys on the field in order to cover the expected pass. So they might want to run the ball against a smaller, lighter lineup with your big guys, and that's exactly what happened on that play. It was tough on them, and now instead of being in third.
Here's Colton Schmidt now, as they're forced to kick for the 6th time today. Fielded at the 20. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And out will come the offense as they take over. Matt Ryan and the offense heading back onto the field. Hard to call this guy a game manager, but that's really all he's needed to do. The running game, fantastic.
And they've actually put themselves in a spot where they're able to close the game out, doing what you would want to do in this situation anyway, run the football. But they don't have to ramp up into it. They're already there. They've been establishing it the entire game.
And now off to the races, down the right side. And they are going to score